Hi, my name is Jose Miguel Barrela, and today I'm going to show you how to connect the Linux-based memcache application to Windows Azure. Let me scope out a little bit of what we'll do today. So we'll have Windows Azure as our cloud provider, and as part of Windows Azure, we'll have two solutions. One will be a VM, which is our Linux VM, where we're going to try and connect our application to the memcache solution that we're building. This VM is just an Ubuntu VM created on Windows Azure. So this VM is running Ubuntu, and it has the libmemcache tools, including memccp and memccat. The other part of the solution, it's a cloud service. This is just a way Azure has of grouping what we call worker roles or custom solutions that are not VM or websites or all the other solutions. So this cloud service, we'll be running an instance. The instance is how Windows Azure provisions the actual fabric or compute resources where the solution will run. This is completely transparent to us. So it has an instance, and inside this instance will roll, let's say it's a dummy worker role, because it isn't actually running anything, but it does have caching enabled, which is what we need. And by doing this, an endpoint is defined. So this cloud service will expose, let's say, TCP 9999, and our VM will use libmemcache tools to connect to this TCP endpoint using native memcache protocol. So similarly, I can any solution that is running on this VM, let's say for example an Nginx server, or let's say a custom application, PHP, Ruby, etc., they all can connect to this TCP solution right here. This is one way of solving this problem. Another canonical way of solving the memcache problem, so there are two. One is Azure Cache Service, which is just a service that you create and start using on your .NET applications using the SDK. The other one is using the shim. So the shim is something that you add to your .NET project using NuGet, and this will, let's say, locally transform your cache request from memcache to the Windows Azure cache API. And this happens locally, so you don't need to actually have an instance, but it runs on the instance where the actual project is running. But here are the two things. The first one is that we're not using the SDK, which makes this solution unrealistic for us. And the other one is that we don't have a .NET application that we can add the NuGet to it. So we'll just use the first approach. So it's very simple. We use Visual Studio Express 2012 for web for this. You just need to create a new project. It's going to be a cloud C# Azure Cloud Service project. After we click on OK, we can choose which type of Azure Cloud Service we want. We can choose a worker role, and so this project creates, and we get something like, let me close solution right here and open the one that I already created. And so it's called Windows Azure 4. Here's the solution. And so this solution has a worker role. And the worker role, we can double click here on the roles, worker role 1. We can right click and select properties. And then we enable caching for this worker role. So right here in the caching tab, we enable caching. And then finally, we need to create an endpoint, as we mentioned. Let's call it memcache default. And then we can set the port. 10100 is here, we can set 9999 or whatever we need. Then we save this and we can build a solution. Since the worker role actually doesn't contain anything, we build a solution, it's going to be pretty easy and pretty simple. And the next step would be to publish this. So we right click on the solution, we select publish, and then we choose our subscriptions, and we if we want to use an existing cloud service, we choose it from here. If we want to create a new cloud service, we also do it from here. And we set the rest of the settings right here, and we click on publish. I won't do it because I already did. But what this will do in the back end is provision the instances and send our small and basically a dummy project over to Windows Azure that will have caching enabled. So this is how it looks. So this is the cloud service. It does have some instances running, but really we haven't defined specifically what needs to happen there. We actually don't even have remote desktop access into it or anything. So we just know that CSI cache01.cloudapp.net, that's my host name, and then I should have an endpoint 10.100 that I can start using now with the memcache native protocol. So to do so, we have the Ubuntu VM right here, and what we'll do is use memccp. We're defining the server right here. It's a host name and the 10.100 port. We're going to send the file. Let's send etc/motd. We can choose verbose and we can choose binary as well, just to see what's going on. So what basically happened here is that the VM sent an entire text file from my file system to the memcache service that is running on this cloud service on Windows Azure. So to check that it's happening, we just need to use memccat. So we point to the same server, and then we use a key, which is defined by this memcache tool when the file is uploaded, which is just the name of the file, so motd, and I should get the actual motd file from memcache. Similarly, I can connect, as I mentioned, an Nginx server or any other application and start using this cache right now. And finally, what I'll do here is I can click and configure, and I can set it. You see that I get my default cache here, and then I can choose the specific options, including high availability, that I want for this cache. So this is how you connect a Linux-based memcache solution to Windows Azure. Thank you.